Good evening, good evening, good evening, and welcome. Welcome one, welcome all. This is our Thursday evening show. We just doing a little mic check before we get this Rhonda Thomas interview going. We're trying to make sure everything is all right. And with just a little bit going on here and there, we are just kicking it tonight and going to enjoy a good time with Rhonda Thomas, who is an extraordinary neo-soul artist. And we have a little while before she comes on, but I wanted to make sure we had a mic check because we had a very horrible malfunction last time. It didn't work out too well. So what we're trying to do now is just do a little mic check, see if everything is working okay. If it is, let's hear from you. So we're going to just play some live stuff just because we want to make sure everything is going okay. That's right. That's right. What's going on, family? What's going on? Got my team Twitter out there, UrbanSouls.com, the Soul FM. It's all good. It's all good. I found a live performance from your girl, Rhonda Thomas, Best Intentions. And I just want to play that for a minute. We got a little minute. Just want to do my little mic check. Soul FM.
But then you smiled at me, I couldn't throw it all away. I had the best of intentions. You did that thing with your eyes, I couldn't say goodbye. Our personalities are so much alike. I don't know if that's good or bad. Don't man. So come and turn as something that I've never had. We're from soul up to lower down to handle our pills with hustles of our own on the side. But this is our problem, I know you. I feel you don't have any time. And I need you to know
I had the best of intentions. Let you go, but then you smile at me. What's up? How you doing? I'm Erica Carson, the host of Harmony in Life. Once again, I have the pleasure of sitting down with Miss Rhonda Thomas.
I mean, he did this thing with his eyes. I couldn't say goodbye.
Now, let's get into who Rhonda Thomas is.
Okay.
Now, you are originally from New York.
I am.
And I don't hear that when I talk to you. You have that soulful, down-home girl flavor about you, so tell me about that.
It must be because I've been here since 1996, but definitely when I get back home to Long Island and Queens,
does it come out
I can
of
bring
you?
All of that back.
Yeah. Oh, there
what?
It is.
What? You know what I'm talking about?
Okay. You have such a connection with fans, and when I see you perform, you just really radiate just this soul and this power, and you're really in the moment. What is that like
well,
for
thank
you?
Thank you. I know that I thrive from the audience. I feel what they feel. When they're vibing and I get their energy, I need that so that I can then sing and project what I need to project.
You have the privilege of being a background singer for one of the all-time great icons, Mr. Isaac Hayes.
It's your thing. I do what you want to. Yeah.
Your thing.
Was just phenomenal to work with. There's no way that I could have worked with him for 11 years if he wasn't.
As we get older, we get set in our ways. We're not so open to change. You see our problems is drama. You think it's too much, but I see them as situations of day to day. Do I listen to my mind and follow my heart? Consider in my mind, look for a while, my heart to the doorway.
Now, while we're speaking of intentions, you have a lot of good intentions for the community in which you live. So what do you do when you're not doing music?
I feed the homeless every Thursday night when I'm in town. I feel like everyone should give back to their community in some capacity, in any way that they can,
definitely.
Whether it's volunteering or, you know, helping children or tutoring. If every person did that at least one day a week, think about how beautiful our world would be.
Now, speaking of women of color, it brings to mind Michelle Obama
mm-hmm.
and our new president, Barack Obama.
Mm-hmm.
Now, what's that been like for you as an artist?
I was actually at the inauguration in D.C., and it was moving and spiritual. My mom was at the March on Washington, so we knew we needed to be a part of history. It's a great day to be African American. It's a great day to be an American. To see his little girls running out on the lawn, that's huge.
Absolutely.
To see their hairstyles, you know, to see them wearing cornrows and braids and pom-poms and all that good stuff, that's unprecedented.
And just relaxing and being real.
Yes.
And approachable.
And to see someone that looks like me in the White House, like me, like you,
mm-hmm.
I'm proud.
She was singing Best Intentions right over there at, she was live at Sugar Hill in downtown Atlanta, and she performed in front of more than 600 people right there at the Harmony and Life television show. You know, I found that and I had to play that. You know, we're doing that mic check, 1, 2, 1, 2, mic check, 1, 2, 1, 2. This is your boy, DJ Tan, right here on the Soul FM, as well as partners with UrbanSouls.com. If you are looking for a cool place to chill, why don't you come on over to UrbanSouls.com? It is free, and it is an urban website designed for people just like you and me. That's what I'm talking about. If you want 24/7 listening, run on over to the Soul FM, where all you have to do is click and listen. That's where we met our girl, Rhonda Thomas. Yes, indeedy. I'm just running my mouth because I don't want nothing to go wrong when she do call. That's what I'm talking about. You know, I found something else on when she was live. It was the Montreal. No, was it the Montreal Jazz Festival? And it was also something else that I had my eye on when she was live in concert. I said, and another thing when she was live at Centennial Olympic. That was a good one also. So you know, Rhonda Thomas. She has a lot going on, and she is one magnificent person. And when we get our chance to have this will be our second live interview with Rhonda Thomas. She has become a very good friend of ours over here at the Soul FM and UrbanSouls.com. And it's one wonderful thing to be able to be in company and be in the mix with people who have good intentions, who have things going on in their life. And we, you know, the purpose of the Soul FM and UrbanSouls.com is to be able to feature people who you can just turn on the radio and be like, oh, because you know how things go in this world. It's not a perfect world. So when you want to listen to some good stuff, sometimes it's not on mainstream radio, although we would like for it to be on mainstream radio. And this is one of our big things. This type of music, Rhonda Thomas and people like her, need to be on mainstream radio. You know, and I don't understand why there's not, but you know, like I said, we're not living in the perfect world. And because we're not in the perfect world, we got problems. But that's all right, because we're going to make it do what it do, and we're going to make it happen. That's right. So come on over, listen to your girl, Rhonda. You know what, before our show starts, we have a few more minutes before our show actually starts. I am absolutely in love with this song, Rhonda Thomas featuring Avery Sunshine. It's called Just Us, and I think I want to play that also. I mean, it's hot. Y'all take a listen right here on the Soul FM. Sunshine, Just Us. Man, that's a finger popping jam. I wanted to put on my skates, man. I wanted to put them on. I wanted to get the you know how I used to flip backwards and do little crisscross stuff? I was ready. Man, I can't wait. That's a bad little song, yeah. But this tonight we are focusing on Rhonda Thomas' Christmas CD. You know, it takes a lot for somebody to come up with a Christmas CD because, you know, it's so flooded with Christmas music, you know, the same Christmas music. I'm not knocking nobody, you know. I'm not knocking nobody. I'm not knocking the music, but I'm just saying that, you know, it takes someone of great talent for Christmas music not to sound like the same old stuff, you know. Without further ado, we are going to be speaking with Rhonda Thomas right now. What's up, baby?
Hola, Poppy. How are you?
What's going on, baby? I'm doing good. We was jamming.
Are we in sync?
Baby, we live
and all the technical difficulties.
Baby, we live and in living color. What?
Yes.
We live and in living color. As a matter of fact, I started the show early just to make sure I had it going on.
That's what I'm talking about.
Man, we've been finger popping your music for about 15 minutes now.
Nice. Oh, that's great.
We've been playing. I played something when you performed live, and I also played. I love that song, Just Us. Oh my goodness, we were snapping. I was like, I wanted to get my skates. Shoot. So, I said, shoot, I got to dig up my skates. They're around here somewhere. I might fall and act a fool, but hey. I'm going to give it a shot.
Well, thank you. I'm glad you like that one. Two tons of fun.
Oh, I'm like, wait a minute. I don't see no tonnage, you know. But I'm right.
No what?
I said tonnage.
Tonnage? What's tonnage?
Tonnage. I said, I don't like that two tons of fun thingy.
Oh, tonnage.
You know, I make up my own words. Tonnage. I didn't see no tonnage.
I see.
I saw some beautiful ladies. I didn't see no tonnage.
But the original group was two tons of fun.
Yes, the original.
Right?
Yes, the original group was two tons of fun. But I had to look at the video twice. I was like, I don't see two tonnage.
Oh, that's
well, family, family, family. We are live and in living color with your girl Rhonda Thomas, who is a most wonderful, wonderful. I don't even know how to call it. I don't want to call her neo soul. She's neo soul, blues, R&B, rap. She be trying to do it all, but wait a minute.
I don't rap.
She be rapping, she be yodeling, all kind of stuff.
Okay, wait a minute. I'm manifesting because my skills are getting ill and chilling. You trying to play me, I'm like a player.
Let's get
all I got. You'll never hear that again anywhere.
Oh, man. Told y'all she be rapping and going on. But wait a minute.
Challenge.
Man, don't get me started because I got my own rap, man. I don't. What? What?
I know you do. You just high power, full of energy. So I already know. I'm worried about you with this interview. I need some liquor.
I am always full of energy when I'm feeling all right. Even when I'm not right, I'm full of energy. You know, I was watching, we were watching a video, Just Us, and I was like, is she really tap dancing? Or are you faking the funk?
I danced before I sang. My mom
kids
me to this day. She said, all those dancing lessons and you just ended up singing? I know she's like, you're going to dance in something.
I know that's right. I said, check out tap dancing and going on. So you just have a plethora of things going on in your life.
I guess so. I'm very blessed. I definitely had to dust off those tap shoes and shake a leg and see what I could do. That was Jay White,
yes,
who was dancing with me. Now, he's a tap dancer extraordinaire. I was just trying to bring it back.
Well, you did pretty good. I was impressed.
Thank you. It was a little more than a shuffle ball change, hop step. Hop step, all of that. Yeah.
Yeah, I saw a little hip-hop. You did the little hip-hop twist, turn, pop, bang. I was like, all right now. So wait a minute. So the last time we spoke with you, what have you been up to since our last conversation?
Oh, my gosh. I presume it's this Christmas CD, which was just a joy to make, and I'm just so blessed and grateful to have a wonderful team and wonderful musicians that stood by me and next to me to make it happen. So let me see. I know I've sung at the Blue Note in New York since we've last spoken.
Okay.
Woo! I've been all over the state gigging. I guess this Christmas album is the biggest thing.
What has been one of the best performances that you've really, really enjoyed? I've noticed you have been all over the world, actually. And so what was your best? Do you like performing outside of the country more so than you like performing here in the U.S., or are you just kind of equal?
There's definitely, I won't say pros and cons to both, but there are just different aspects of each that I like. The overseas crowd, the U.K. audience, was just so welcoming and warm. I mean, they still contact me to this day. When are you coming back? When are you coming back? And they're very attentive, and they love soul music. Even our classic soul artists, you see how they can go back to the U.K. and perform the sold-out shows. And here, they don't always have that opportunity,
right,
you know?
Right.
So, I mean, it's the same for indie artists over there. They just eat us all up. They love it. So I would say some of the shows over there in England were some of my favorite.
Do you find
one of my most favorite? Go ahead.
No, you go ahead.
What'd you say?
Go ahead.
Oh, I was gonna say one of my most favorite with Isaac Hayes overseas was the Montreal Jazz Festival, just because you get to see all those different artists and the crowd is just electric, but they're so attentive that they don't start roaring and getting all excited till the very end. So you're not even sure if they're digging it, but they're like, yeah! So.
Now, how did you meet up with the legendary Isaac Hayes? How did you become a part of his crew?
Jesus.
Come on now, preach on.
That's who it was. It was the Lord, because I moved here from Connecticut, and I was just singing in clubs. Different jam sessions. I didn't have any major gigs yet. I was really just testing the waters and trying to find my place. And there are people contacting me and asking me if I wanted to go out on the road and tour with him. And the rest was history. I didn't even have to audition. So they were looking for a bass player at the time, two background vocalists. So I got the spot, and my friend Kurt Mitchell, we started at the same time. He plays bass, and it was just on and popping from then on.
Wow, that is amazing. And who else have you did background for?
Roy Ayers, Sam Moore. Hmm?
I said, woo woo.
Oh, that's right.
That's before.
Searching. That's my jam right there.
Go ahead.
Woo!
I'm bopping. Go ahead.
Talking to this old lady back, and they just cool, and they put you in the mood. It's just like taking a long drive on the coast when you listen to Roy Ayers.
Yes.
And he was really cool to work with. I sang background for Sam Moore of Sam and Dave. Trying to think of some folks. I shared the stage with Luther, but I don't really feel like I can claim Luther Vandross, because he came to a club and heard me singing and joined the stage with me, and we sang together because I was scatting.
Wow.
And he was looking at me like, wow, and he wanted to jump in and get some of that. So, you know, that was my Luther moment.
Wow, that's amazing. I claim him, and I just was in the same concert hall with him. I claim him. That's my friend. I don't care what nobody say. I act like I knew him. That's my brother-in-law.
Okay.
All kind
wow.
of stuff.
Wow.
I get all kind of.
Y'all have Thanksgiving is together back in the day, right?
What? You better ask somebody. Shoo. When Michael Jackson died, I couldn't function. I'm telling you, I act like that. See, like people be like,
wow.
Well, Rhonda Thomas, that's my homegirl. Just like that.
Perez, I tell you. But
just
yeah,
like
it was just great to have all those different experiences with different artists, and you eat the fish and spit out the bones. You
there
take
you
the
go.
Good and you leave the bad, and you just learn. It's all a learning experience, and I'm just blessed to be able to have so many great people around me to learn from. People think it's real easy to be an indie artist because we make it look easy, but if you don't have the hard times, you don't know what good is.
That's right. I agree with you 100%.
There was a lot of good with this, though. It's been really well received. It's on our CD's been featured on the home pages of iTunes, the R&B page, and the main page.
Yes.
So, and then people like you playing it and embracing it just validates all of our hard work.
Now let me ask you a question. How did you come up with the title Little Drummer Girl?
Mark Nelson, who is a fabulous vocalist and keyboardist here in Atlanta. I actually think Ron Smith, my business partner, mentioned it to him. I could be wrong with that. Mentioned the idea to him, but he took that and wrote a song, which was kind of based on a little drummer boy, and talks about the commercialism behind Christmas and how people should focus on, you know, just giving of yourself and of your heart. So he wrote the majority of the song, and I wrote the very end of it. And if you notice, all my albums, actually, all of my CDs, all four. Hey, I have four, Chan. And
yes,
cool.
You do.
All four. One of the songs on the CD is the title track, and so I've named the albums after one of the songs, and so we just followed suit. My initial CD, Guess Who I Saw Today,
right,
was based on a Nancy Wilson song, Guess Who I Saw Today, and then Breathe New Life, which was written by Al Smith, that was the title track, and then Listen was another fabulous song. I just love all those chord changes. Tyrone Gray came up with that, but here we go. Little Drummer Girl, okay. Mark Nelson and Malik Onay and myself. I really liked the reference to the actual little drummer girl, little drummer boy, being able to give from your heart. And then because I'm so percussive in my vocals, I do a lot of scatting and, you know, just different vocal styling. That had me. I was like, hey, I could be the little drummer girl. Let's just name it Little Drummer Girl.
Yeah. I mean, it's a great title. I mean, especially for... you know, the reason for the season and everything. You know, a lot of people don't understand the premise of the Little Drummer Boy. You know, I think commercialization has come so full circle in our world that people forget the true meaning of what these songs actually meant. You see?
You better preach that.
You know,
and it
is. And, you know, and people are so, you know, like Silent Night. I mean, you know, I don't have nothing against the Temptations and nobody else that sang it, but you know, you hear that hoo 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 hoo, that whole thing there, you know, you get up and start finger popping and finger snapping, and you forget what the words actually mean. You know, you sitting up there drinking your vodka and your eggnog, but you forgetting what the words actually mean. You know, so
you talking about in my mind?
Come on now.
Mess it up.
Shoot, I want to be free. Yeah, all that. You can't, you know, you forget the word. You doing with the head. You know?
Oh, you are so right, because a lot of these songs are hymns.
Right.
You know?
They're
and
all about.
I will say this. I like the fact that we did take a lot of these standard classic songs and we switched them up. And we do have three originals and seven covers. And the covers do have a different flavor, a different flair, but I like that we give the listeners some funk and some soul and some jazz and then some contemporary, but we also give them the traditional with the songs O Come, Emmanuel and O Holy Night.
That's right. That's right. Now, were you concerned at all that the market was so flooded with Christmas music? How did you ensure that your sound would be so different? Because actually the sound of it is very, very different. You know, it's not something that you're like, oh Lord, I've heard this before. Okay, here we go. It's very different. So how did you ensure that?
Honestly, this is probably the first time I've said this in an interview. I had a lot of trepidations going into recording this CD because I've always had a lot of control over my music, and this time I commissioned a team of friends and family to come together and do the arrangements on these songs for me. And they had been working on them for months. I had chosen the songs that I wanted to sing, and they worked on the arrangements. And I was a little worried, Tan. I was like, okay, I usually take a lot of time. I'm very meticulous. I'm very hands-on. And are they going to really get what I want to convey? Because you can have plenty of producers that are fabulous, but do they get the artist? Is it going to be a great match? And if I don't like it, am I going to be able to express that to my friends? And are we going to even have time to change anything? And I remember telling my friend and bass player, Dexter Whitaker, you know, pray for me because I'm really trying to have faith. And not in a negative way, not to say that they couldn't make it happen, but right. Everybody doesn't vibe. So I put it in, you know, the hands of a higher power, and voila, these brothers and sisters, they came with it. They understood what I wanted to convey. They listened to me, and they saw my sound and my style. And if you listen to the CD, it's kind of laid back. Those first couple of tracks, Little Drummer Girl, I'm not over singing. That's what Christmas means to me. I'm letting the track do the work, right. And we're just kind of bobbing and weaving together. We're flowing,
right?
You know?
Right.
And that's what we wanted to convey. We didn't want too much, you know, all over the place, a whole lot of this and that. I will say on We Three Kings, I think we're jamming musically with the dynamics of the musicians and that whole live jazz element feel. And then My Favorite Things, we make it really soulful, and it has the Al Green kind of maybe Staples vibe.
Yes,
but
yes.
I'm not really hooping and hollering on this CD because it's Christmas
right.
to me. And right. I wanted it to have a type of reverence, and I wanted it to have a type of respect, but I still wanted people to feel it and have the experience.
Right, and I think you pretty much nailed it in terms of what you set out to do. I was listening to it, and I absolutely like the way the twist. I like the twist. You know, it's not it's Christmas, but then you have a little twist. You know, and it makes a lot of sense because you know in this world we have a lot of things that we want and need in this life. You know, and listening to the way that the lyrics are turned, you know, it makes a lot of sense. And it's something you can cuddle up and you know, have a half a glass of wine and decorate your Christmas tree and, you know, do all these things that Christmas is actually all about, you know. And I try to tell people all the time that it's really, you know, the commercialization is get out the mall and get out of Walmart. And just put some music on and sit back and relax and understand the words will tell you what Christmas actually means. You know, and I think that's what you nailed.
Thank you. The head of my team was Al Ross. He was the producer, engineer, mixer, master extraordinaire, and Justin Burstyn assisted him with that, engineering and mixing and mastering. Mark Nelson, Malik O'Neill, Tony White, and Ed Robinson, they all did a lot of the arrangements and the vocal harmonies. And then my band, I'll just mention them briefly, Rod Harris on guitar, Dexter Allen Whitaker on bass out of North Carolina, and Leon Alexander III out of D.C. And what's really cool about Leon, he drove all the way out from D.C., and he plays in the Navy band for President Obama. So
wow. We're
trying to get him to get a little something to the president so it can be in his iPod and he could be jamming as some Little Drummer Girl because you know he would be getting down.
That's right. You know,
and I didn't want to leave out, I'm missing somebody. Oh, Tyrone Jackson on keys.
All right.
Fabulous.
All right.
I'm blessed. I'm just blessed.
You know, and you sound like you are incredibly blessed. You know, a lot of people, you know, they have a lot of success, but success doesn't necessarily mean that you're blessed. You know, and people
right.
tend
That's
to,
right.
you know, you can make, I mean, I know a whole lot of artists that make mega millions and still are very unhappy individuals, you know.
Miserable.
Yeah. So, you know, you got to be not just successful, but you have to be happy.
Right.
You know?
And I think things have to come in its time. I know that I'm being groomed and my team and my family and my musicians, we're being groomed for something better. Something higher,
that's
and
right.
we're just going through the trenches right now, and things happen when they're supposed to.
That's
and
right.
sometimes you're just not ready for what's going to come your way. And there have been times where I've performed in different cities, and the band didn't really know my stuff exactly, but I had to work it out and figure out how to make that show work because the audience paid to come hear me perform,
that's
you know,
right.
and as an in- as an indie artist, you're not always able to bring your band and your people with you, and I use those as learning experiences. I learned from that how to navigate that situation so that there's a positive outcome.
Now, at Christmas in Rhonda Thomas' house growing up, did that have a lot of influence on who you are as an entertainer?
as an entertainer, I guess maybe that's twofold, because who I am as an entertainer does come from my upbringing,
right,
and what's been instilled in me. And we've had a lot of tradition in our home. It's funny, my brother, I have to tell this story. He came home one day to his wife. He lives in North Carolina now, in Charlotte, and she had decorated the whole tree, and, you know, everything, the presents were all under the tree. And she noticed a couple days he was just kind of solemn. And, you know, she was like, what's wrong? And he's like, well, you know, you decorated the tree, and we're doing that as a family.
Wow.
And don't you know, that's some love right there, because she took all the decorations off the tree.
Oh, no, that's love. That's love.
That's love or insanity, but okay, we'll say it's love.
Well, but you know, sometimes love can be insane, so we can call that a little bit of both.
That's true. That's very true. So I say that to say our family time was always like a week before Christmas. We would go with my dad to go get a tree, a live tree. I've never had a Christmas without a live tree.
Wow.
And then we decorate the tree, and my dad would, actually, it was the night before. It was always Christmas Eve we would get the tree, because we would put the cookies out for Santa, and we would watch different cartoons. And, you know, I know my parents were somewhere wrapping presents, but I did believe in Santa then. And we just had great family time. My parents were divorced at the time, but we just all came together then. My brother, my father, and myself, we had the fireplace, you know, going, the eggnog, making cookies, decorating the tree. I mean, in the morning, Christmas morning, we would always watch the Macy's Day Parade and then the dog show. It wasn't until I saw my father eating cookies one year, and I was like, there ain't no Santa Claus.
How,
I'm going to tell you, Chan, that really did mess me up.
How old were you when you realized that?
I might have been maybe like 8.
Oh, my goodness.
Maybe 8. That was devastating. I was like, he's eating cookies. And he's drinking them milk. And then they're going to act like Santa ate it.
When I found out there was no Santa, when I tell you I was so devastated, I didn't even want nothing for Christmas. I say, I can't believe it.
Right, this is a travesty. We've been hoodwinked and bamboozled.
Been bamboozled, hoodwinked. You trying to tell me ain't no big white dude come from out this thing? Are you serious? All these years,
right.
I've been making cookies. You really? And then see,
right.
My kids are like that.
Cookies.
My kids, I got to whisper, because I got a baby that she still believes in Santa Claus. And she made some cookies.
Oh, yeah.
She made some cookies last year. And, oh, Jesus, they were so nasty.
Oh, that's hilarious.
Oh,
what'd you do with the cookies?
Well,
did you eat the cookies or you throw them out?
I ate the cookies, and then
you ate them?
She brought me some juice with her fingers in the juice glass.
How old is your daughter, though?
She at that time last year, she was 5. So
she was 5?
She's 5. So she had the cup. No, this happened. This wasn't last Christmas. I take that lie back. She was 3 when this happened. And she put her fingers in the cup, and then she licked it. Yeah, Daddy. I said, oh, man.
Yeah, that's that love right there.
Yeah,
that's
that
caring.
That's that Christmas
love.
Man, my stomach was hurting so bad, it didn't make no sense.
Because I would do them cookies out. I'm sorry.
When you got a child that's staring at you saying, is it good? You like, yeah.
You couldn't, like, pour the juice in the plant pot like they do on TV?
You ain't had no plant pot.
You couldn't, like, slip it to the dog underneath the table like they do on TV?
We ain't had no dog.
Oh, I'm sorry, man. You had to just take the bullet. You had to take the hit.
My children, we had one dog, you know, and had to get rid of him because I just don't, mean animals don't mix. I don't like all that licking and all that stuff. I don't like all that foolishness. So he had to get rid of him. But, you know, every time I talk to you, Rhonda, we get so off key. We be talking about.
You're right.
Yeah, but that's the sign
you're
of a
right.
good person, you
we'll
know.
Bring it back.
Everybody in the chat room laughing and going on. Let me give some shout-outs up in the chat room. We got, starting from the very tip-top, you got your girl DJ Jazzy Rella. She does our Wednesday show, and we'll be starting our Neo Soul podcast very soon. You got your girl Ave Maria in the building, Cheryl L. Yarber in the building. You got the CEO of UrbanSouls.com, Dante in the building. You got your girl Dito's in the building, Devereaux, also known as Uncle D from Sydney, Australia, in the BZ. You got... Hey, DJ Haas in the building. And your girl, Isis. And I know I'm forgetting everybody because... let me scroll. Oh, I got to scroll. Oh, well. You got your girl, Isis, in the building. And everybody's waving and going on. So what I'm going to do, I'm scared to put this thing on mute because y'all know how Spreaker be acting with us. You know they don't like us. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to play it from the speaker. Let's see here.
Okay.
What was it like performing with Eric Robeson?
Oh, he's a gem. He is just, I mean, I can't say enough good things about Eric. He really gets what we're trying to do on this indie scene and in this music arena. And he was gracious enough to bless us with his vocals on the CD. And he really is Mr. Nice Guy. So I only have good words for Eric Robeson. Very professional, very timely, really listens to you. I think it's cool when an artist takes the time to talk to each of their fans and doesn't just look through them. I learned that from actually Malcolm Jamal Warner. I watched him just talking to people and not through them or waiting to talk to the next person. Eric is really good about that. And we've worked together on numerous occasions before he agreed to sing on this track. And he's just like a prince. It's magical.
Wow. Well, what we're going to do right now is I'm going to pull it up from another place so I can play it. And this is Rhonda Thomas. It's called Mistletoe featuring Eric Robeson.
Yay!
Yeah. Wait, what they going to... Wait, I got to play the commercial first. Wait. Hold on. Well, yeah. They do us. You know, we got to be all straight. You know, I don't want to call it ghetto, but...
Right.
You know, you got to do what you got to do in this industry to get where you need to be.
And
I don't have a problem with it at all. At all.
Okay.
Now, let's see here. Here we go. All right. Rhonda Thomas.
It's just an excuse to be close to you.
Favorite symbol of the season because of you.
Kiss me, baby, hold me tight, you know the rules.
It's Christmas time and we're under mistletoe. Oh, it's Christmas time and we're under mistletoe. Yesterday, the leaves were changing and fall was underway. Now it's cold outside. You're wrapped up in my arms and the fire's burning bright.
Warmth from the orange glow. When I look in your eyes,
in your
something
eyes,
in me knows the season is joy to me. Makes it all complete.
It's just an excuse to be close to you. My favorite symbol of the season because of you.
Kiss me, baby. Hold me tight, you know the rules.
It's Christmas time and we're under mistletoe.
Ooh,
oh. It's Christmas time and we're under mistletoe. All up on each other, but you so easy. Smile as you walk by, knowing it's our tradition. Linger for a while, know that I'm gonna kiss you.
So what you waiting for? It's hanging from the door. For us to kiss up under. Oh yes, I know you wondered just how it got there. It's no real mystery. I put it down for us. Now won't you come to me?
It's just an excuse to be close to you. Favorite symbol of the season because of you.
Kiss me, baby, hold me tight, you know the rules.
It's Christmas time and we're under mistletoe.
Ooh, ooh, yeah.
It's Christmas time and we're under mistletoe.
Let's steal this moment while they wrap presents neath the tree.
Close your eyes.
There's no one
here but you and me.
An excuse to be close to you.
My favorite symbol of the season because of you.
Kiss me, baby, hold me tight, you know the rules.
It's Christmas time and we're under mistletoe. It's Christmas time and we're under mistletoe. It's Christmas time and we're under mistletoe. It's Christmas time and we're under mistletoe.
Hey, I had it going on. That's going straight to
me. Real glad you were digging that one.
I'm digging it, and you know what? That's going straight to my iPod.
That's going straight to my iPod.
That is it's so smooth. Oh my goodness.
Thank you. I really think that Eric just finessed that. I like that bouncy melody that Martin Nelson came up with. He wrote his verses, and I wrote mine in the bridge, and that just bouncy melody, and it's really flirty, our lyrics that, you know, just weave back and forth with each other. Eric nailed it.
You both nailed it. I mean,
thank you.
Is lovely. I really, 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 really love that. You know, it's just the fact that, like I said before, you always looking for something that's a little different, you know, and this is totally on a totally different realm from what everybody else is. And like I said, I'm not knocking anybody else because I'm going to get a million emails. You said that. That's why I pay for my own radio show. I say what I want and I mean what I say. Right here.
Wow.
AM/FM. You know, so, I mean, I like the fact that you could find something that's different, that something that is catchy, something that can be played for years and years and years to come. You know, like I said, the mainstream stuff is all nice and all good, but sometimes, especially when you're giving a party, you know, like we have a Christmas party on a Saturday, and I'm going to be playing this at the Christmas party. Because
we're gonna be
snapping at this Christmas party, you know, and because this adds to the luster of just your every holiday jams, you know, and
yeah,
I think
that's what I'm hearing. I'm hearing that people are wanting something new and different. And you asked me before, what was the impetus or how did I know that I'd be able to record something that would be different and wouldn't get lost in the shuffle of Christmas songs? And I think you have to make a conscious effort to do that. You can't just write a Christmas album or record a Christmas album thinking, okay, I'm just going to record this because I can sell it every year. Right. And I don't want to change it too much because, you know, people like what they hear and I don't want to change. Yeah, come on, take a risk. Do you? We need to have our own songs from this generation that can be classics.
And you are right. This generation, we need, like, you know, like I said, you know, okay, from the 80s to the 70s, the 60s, okay, enough is enough. It's nice when you first hear it, but we got December, we got this week, next week.
Right.
And
I
would like to have some different stuff, you know, and like I say all the time, you know, the best music. And again, I'm not knocking anybody, but the best music is always not mainstream music. The best players are always those who you have to go search out their CD. You have to go on their website and say, wait a minute, let me see if I can get some new music here. You know, and that's the premise behind a lot of our internet radio, because of the fact that you're tired of hearing the same thing. Yeah, we have old school on Friday nights because that's our feel-good music. And that was when we was jamming. We could remember putting the plastic on the couches and your mama kicking your butt because you tore the plastic. You know, that's but you have to go back to, wait a minute. Something is different here about this lady. There, something is different about Rhonda Thomas. And when you listen to Rhonda Thomas's music, that tells you that you're steadfast in the love of what you do. And that's what makes
it. You need to write a review of my CD.
I will write a review.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, that's...
Wow, I got the whole tapestry, and you just, I love that. Thank you. I'm going to piggyback on what you're saying. There are so many people that are just unaware that indie artists and their music even exist. The average person that's out on the street or listening to your classic soul station, they don't even think that there's any other music out there.
Exactly.
They really don't. And there's more and more generations of people, young grandmothers raising their daughters' daughters. They don't know. And they're thinking, okay, well, this is all there is. This is what we're being fed.
Right.
Clearly, if there was music, we'd be privy to it. And it's the, like you said, it's those who make a conscious effort to seek, and then you find an abundance of music that is just at our beck and call. Satellite radio, internet radio, you just have to go search it out.
You do. You have to search out the music. You know, I have a DJ, DJ Haas. DJ Haas does Steppers music, and he's from Chi-Town. You know, and he does stepper sets on Saturdays. And when I tell you, the audience is huge, because not a whole lot of people understand steppers music. They're like, wait, what is this? Wait a minute, what is this? Now, you know, if you're coming from West Coast or you're coming from someplace like that, you're not going to understand it, or you're not going, not that you've even heard it. You know, so when I heard it, I was like, whoa, I got to put this brother on my station, because this is something else that is different and eclectic. You know, and just like we're opening up our neo-soul and different genres in that level, because it's a need for it, you know. And we will have that station as well, where we will play nothing but new artists and artists that are not mainstream. And that is our goal, as a matter of fact, to launch this weekend, you know. So we are moving in that direction to accommodate all of you, you know. All of the Rhonda Thomases of this world, we are moving to accommodate that, because it's something that needs to happen. And if we don't make it happen, it's not going to happen.
That's right. I'm so glad you're taking this charge, and you are spearheading this, because it is up to us. I was talking to someone the other day about how we've given blues away and we've given jazz away. You know, we've given our music away, and it's our fault. We're not retaining it. We're just about the dollar, you know? What's going to make the fast, quick money, and we're not trying to sustain really good music for our kids. It's up to us to leave it to the next generation. It's up to us to create it, and it's up to us to leave it for the next generation. And we need to take that charge. And I appreciate you doing what you do. And I made a comment the other day that there needs to be affirmative action for indie artists. And on mainstream radio, every 3 or 4 major label artist songs they play, they should play an indie artist song.
That's right. They should. You know, but the thing of it is, the commercialization of the whole radio, the whole, you know, it's ridiculous. And it's money talks. And it's crazy. I mean, I come from a place where, you know, people say, I've listened to all kinds of music. You know, but I was raised on pretty much drums and tribal type music, because I was raised actually in a village, so I didn't have the accommodations of radio and all this stuff. You know, we played our own music. We thought we was jamming until we got to the city. We were like, well, this ain't what we played.
Right, okay.
You know? But, you know,
fabulous.
With my children and with them growing up, you know, I always showed them different realms of music. You know, a lot of times you get tired of the same old, how many times can you snap it, flip it, bend it over, pop it? How many times can you do that?
They can't even listen to the music. They can't listen to regular radio.
I was driving to, I was driving this morning, and I said, wait a minute. I heard the same song three times within 45 minutes. You know, I heard it three times. You know, and I am not even going to say the artist because he might call me and cuss me out. But I was like, okay, so you're going to dive. Okay, so, okay. I have a question from Isis 1769. She hails from Las Vegas, Nevada. She wants to know, where was your most favorite location you have performed at and why?
Oh, my. I loved performing in Chicago because the audience was electric and they received my music so well. It was early on when I performed music from my CD, Breathe New Life, and I was also out with this group, Jiva. I'm sorry, I can't remember the venue, but the place was just electric, on fire. They bought a whole bunch of CDs, and it was the first time that my original material was heard.
Great, great. Now, we have a question from, Dito's going to kill me, because every time she has a question for one of our artists, I forget where she's from. Springfield, that's right.
Okay, from Springfield, Massachusetts.
Springfield, Dina, where you from? She gonna kill me every time I do this to her. But anyway, from Deedles, let's see. Her question is, what is your fondest Christmas memory?
Making these cookies as a little kid, some recipe my mom found, I was going to say on the internet, not back then on the internet.
I'm like, what kind of internet she had? I'm like, wait a minute.
She found this recipe where you could make these cookies and they would harden and you could decorate them and we were able to hang them on the tree. And so just the family time, I'm really big on the family time, the family aspect of Christmas, coming together, focusing on what the holiday is about. But that was my fondest memory. My mom, my brother, my dad, and us coming together and everybody getting along Christmas Eve. Those were the times for me. Nowadays, my brother's in Charlotte. My father lives in St. Croix, Virgin Islands. Wow. My mom lives like 3 minutes from me here in Atlanta. So she and I, we have big Thanksgiving dinners together. I had 14 people at my house for Thanksgiving. Yeah. But Christmas is usually a little more laid back. It's just my mom and I, and we end up making gumbo every year.
Man, I just had gumbo.
New Orleans.
I just had me some chicken and sausage gumbo. Oh, boy, that's the best taste of stuff.
I know.
Oh, my goodness. And we, again, cannot wait to see you come through the NO, most definitely.
We need to make that happen, Chan.
We need to make it happen.
We got to get our feelers out there and really start working. I'll be recording new music in January, and we'll definitely be setting up different places to perform. Here in Georgia, my CD release party is December 21st. It's a CD release concert, I should say. We had a listening party at Moods Music here in Atlanta last month.
I'm very, very excited
about this.
That's going to be awesome. It's going to be at the Southwest Arts Center,
right?
Oh, my
God. Yes, and it's a beautiful facility. It's like a theater, and we have a lot of special surprises for everyone. And if they want to know more about it, they can go to my website, www.rhonda.sings.com. You can purchase tickets on the website. You can also purchase the CD there. Yes. And we have this campaign. We have this campaign running. If you buy five or more, I will autograph them. You can supply me with the name. Autograph them. Yeah, write the person's name on it, and you can give them as personalized gifts for Christmas.
All right, now, how cool is that, family? How cool is that to have a personalized CD from the Rhonda Thomas? The Rhonda Thomas. And again, her CD release concert is going to be December 21st at Southwest Arts Center in the ATL. Doors open at 7:30. Don't be late. You know how y'all do. Be crossing over people at 8:30.
Right.
Don't act up like that. Y'all know how y'all do.
Meet me there.
Yes.
Beat me there. Don't meet there. Beat me there.
Right. Don't be like, oh, well, wait. Excuse me. Pardon me. Excuse me. And Dino's hails from Illinois. All right now, Illinois. And she also
She's
from Illinois. And she also wanted to know, she has too many questions, so I'm going to have to sift through her stuff. Does she remember?
That's okay, I'm ready.
Her next question is, let's see, as a nutritionist, she carried it to her adult. Okay, does she remember any line of a Christmas speech she said as a child or teenager?
A Christmas line of a speech?
You know, Dito's is a little off. Just, we're going to entertain.
I don't think I gave any Christmas speeches. I'm trying to think, maybe in church. I think I sang more Christmas songs than speeches. I'm sorry. I'm kind of bombing out with the questions. I could make something up, but that wouldn't be real.
I'm weak. Man, I'm weak. I can't take it away. only deals would come up with something. You know, it's like saying, you know, I have a dream.
I go through a lot of plays, Christmas plays. But I don't think I've ever given a Christmas speech. I'm sorry.
see, she lives in a little town, you know, where, like, they know everybody, you know, so they have little speeches and
things. Oh, okay.
You know, she's not from the real world where, you know, big cities, we don't do that kind of stuff. Oh, my goodness. You know.
Did she have another question? You said she had a lot of questions.
Let me
see
what this question is here. Good Lord Jesus. All right. What Christmas traditions has she carried with her into adulthood?
Decorating the tree, always having a live tree. All of my Christmas ornaments are musical or African related, or African American related. So they're really cool ornaments. I love that about my tree. But I'd have to say decorating the tree, going to church, making sure that I give thanks where thanks is due, not getting too bogged down with the commercialism, but definitely the tradition of the tree. That's the main one.
Yeah, that is a good tradition to have, because a lot of times, you know, I hear people say all the time, you know, times is hard and times is bad, and I'm not going to put up a tree. What does that have to do with times being hard? That should make you want to smile, you know, but, you know, we try our best on the Soul FM and UrbanSouls.com to, you know, to make people understand that no matter how bad your situation is, keep on moving, because it's going to get better. It may not get better when you want it to get better, but it's going to get better, most definitely, you know?
Of course. Definitely. That's right. Of course it is. Well, and even if you can't purchase a real tree, maybe you can get a fake tree.
Get a big fake tree from Big Lots.
Get it during the Christmas, get it during the summertime so that you'll have it, you know, get it on sale.
Go to Walmart, they got them for $50 right now. See, let me tell you something, I got a fake tree. I'm going to tell you why I got a fake tree. I have, my poor children, they just weren't privy to real trees because I'm allergic to tree spiders. So one time I was getting a tree and I was, you know, in Louisiana, you be wearing flip-flops and shorts during Christmas because it's just that warm sometimes. So I got the tree. It was a big, beautiful tree, too. Boy, that spider bit me on my toe, and I was headed to the ER. So therefore, my children, they can only look at them, but we can't bring them in the house.
So, I ain't mad at you. I'm not mad at you. You know, the other thing I think about trees, sometimes I've thought about just having a tree in a pot and bringing it in each year. I know it would probably outgrow that pot.
Right.
You know, what can you do? I just love a live tree. My friend Dwayne Colbert at Christmas Tree Express, I'm going to be getting my tree from him tomorrow night, and he delivers.
Oh, well, look at you. You get a delivery. Yeah. Maybe if I get a tree, but somebody can spray it before they bring it in my house. You know,
maybe. Oh, mercy.
We have a question from Ave Maria, and she actually hails from Spain, actually, but she's no longer in Spain, but... So she has a question. She wants to know, are you single?
But yes, I am.
Uh-oh. All right, brothers out there that got something going on, I'm not talking about y'all that's shaking the thing at the grocery store. I'm not talking about you just on the freeway selling fruit. I'm talking about men that have something going on with yourself. Rhonda Thomas is single.
Wait. She asked if I was single, but she didn't ask if I was looking for somebody.
Are you looking for somebody?
No.
All right. Okay, let me retract my statement. Don't hit up Rhonda Thomas if she ain't looking for a soul.
It's going to be all about the music. What other songs do you like from the CD?
I knew that question was coming up, and I knew somebody was going to ask it, so I said, I'm just going to sit back and watch.
Who asked that question again?
Ave.
Who asked that?
Her name is Ave.
Ave, okay.
Ave Maria.
Well, thanks for your question, Ave. Yeah.
Oh,
I love
funny.
It.
She's cracking up. They're cracking up laughing in the chat room. For those who are not members of UrbanSouls.com, UrbanSouls.com is a social website built for people like us, for us. And it's just like Facebook, but it's for us, for us. And we have a good time over at UrbanSouls.com. Registration is free. Y'all come on over and visit UrbanSouls.com as well as the Soul FM. That's what we do.
And all your listeners and folk in the chat room, I love that interaction that you have with them, and I thank them for all their questions and for even being interested in listening and, you know, trying to find out info about me. I'm honored and blessed, so thank you.
You know, we will always follow you, and we will always be grateful for the opportunity to be able to talk with you whenever you have something that's going on. You have my phone number. You can just holler up at me and say, look, I got this going on. Let's do it. Because, you know, like I said, we love artists who have a heart. That's the way I put it.
Aww.
You know, I want to let you guys know, Rhonda Thomas is real. She's a sweetheart. And you guys run on over there and get her music. You can get her music on iTunes as well as... I'll let you say that because I act like I'm...
You were doing great. You were doing wonderful. It's available on iTunes and Amazon.com, CD Baby. You can download it, iTunes and Amazon. You can get physical copies on my website, RhondaSings.com, and CD Baby. And if you're in Atlanta, Moods Music, in Houston, Sirius Sounds, in Philly, Sounds Market and Jazz Sounds, and in Chicago, Dusty Groove.
Wonderful. And also, we have a real big treat also. You can also, if you have an iPhone, an Android phone, or a smartphone, you can download the Rhonda Thomas app, baby.
I like you, because you remember stuff that I don't remember.
iPad, Android, if you got a Kindle Fire, download that app, baby, because I got it on there. And what it is, wait, let me pull it up right quick.
Wait. Well, all right now.
So what
I ain't mad at you.
What it does is... You click on the app, and it has like where she's going to be. It has all her performances. You can listen to music on her app. It's amazing. It's a very, very nice app, and she has a cute little white dress on and everything.
that's the cover of the Listen CD, I believe.
That's the one, and it's very nice. So if you guys have an iPhone, Android phone, smartphone that has apps, you can cop that app right now. Because then that way you will know
Thank
where
you.
She is at all times, like I do. That's right.
And your listeners can correspond with me from the app.
That's
like
right.
Any website. And you can get all types of information. You can tell me what you're doing. You can tell me how you like the CD. It was generated and put together by my good friend Ed Scott of Axel Apps. I guess Axel Apps. Somebody needs to send me a text. I can get it right on the air with Tam Perez. I don't want to say the information wrong. But Ed Scott, awesome. He developed my website for me. And Sid Washington does all my graphics. So I'm just blessed to have really good folk around me. I have no complaints, I tell you.
That is a most,
life is good.
That is a true blessing. Not only is she going to be at Southwest Arts Center on the 21st, but you guys can also catch her at the Ritz-Carlton Hotel Buckhead on the 14th. That's going to be a private event, though. I don't know how that works, but you can also catch her at the Georgia International Convention Center. It's also a private event, but I don't know how that works if you hook it up. You hook it up, you know. And then on the 23rd, right before Christmas, she's going to be at Impact Church doing that thing on December 23rd at 10 a.m.
All three services. We need to change that. 8, 10, and 12.
8, 10, and 12. So come on over to Impact Church and come let us adore him on December 23rd.
Right.
You guys,
my church is very progressive. Pastor Olu Brown is the pastor, and I'll be singing songs from my Christmas CD on that Sunday, the 23rd.
Wonderful. And if you guys want to book anybody out there that would like to book Rhonda Thomas, just go on over to Rhonda Sings, click on Book Rhonda, and then hit your information in there. It's just that simple. You know, Rhonda, I absolutely adore talking with you because I like talking with real people who are down to earth. And we truly appreciate you taking the time out of your schedule because, you know, just the other day, we was just toe up from the flow up. I didn't even gonna lie about it. We was really messed up.
Y'all were really fine, you know. I was trying to hang in with you and, you know, let you guys figure it out, and you finally just were like, okay, you know what? We're going to do this another day. And I was right with you, so it was cool. We made it happen.
I said, you know what? Is something happening that's going to make it a better day? Because when God closes the door, he most certainly opens a window. So we wasn't worried about one thing. So right now, we want to thank you, and we're going to hit this song up. This is called Little Drummer Girl. You guys make sure you cop that CD. Five or more, you're going to get personalized signature. That's what I'm talking about.
That's right. I'll mail them out to you personally. I need to mention one more thing.
Okay.
I did get a text, and it is Axel Online, AXELL Online, and that's Ed Scott, and he does those apps. He puts those apps together.
Oh, wonderful. I'm going to have to hit you up so we can get an UrbanSouls.com app.
He's your man. Is your man. Just let me know. We'll make that happen.
Wonderful. We most certainly enjoyed this interview. Our listeners, Team Twitter, we love you guys. I have the best Twitter team ever. I got the best Urban Souls followers, the best The Soul FM followers. You guys make it happen. And we're going to make sure we always keep Rhonda Thomas in the mix. Like always, in parting, we wish you nothing but love, peace, and UrbanSouls.com, baby.
Wait a minute. You made me forget something.
What?
My Facebook is Rhonda Thomas.
That's right.
And my Twitter is Ron Vocals.
Okay.
So you can reach out all those social media avenues. And the website, RhondaSings.com. And Tam Perez, thank you for being you. Thank you for sticking through this and allowing this interview to happen again. Thank you for just being there on my side and allowing the folk to be able to hear this music. Thank you for believing in me. I don't take that lightly.
We will always.
And I'm very grateful.
Always. And keep in touch with me and make sure we keep up, make sure we keep our listeners know everything that's going on with you because we're going to make it happen. To the New Orleans circuit is going to make it happen. We're going to do this thing.
I promise I will let you know.
All
thank
right.
you.
God bless you, my dear. Right now, we're going to hear Little Drummer Girl.
It's all about the gifts. The price tag shows the value of your relationship. They'll even help you decide exactly what to give. Something shiny or something new, pick one off my Christmas list. But what about a girl like me who hasn't much to give? Can I celebrate the Savior's birth without expensive gifts? Now it doesn't mean that I've come without an offering. But what I have is from my heart, just for the newborn king. I'll play my drum for him. I'll give my best to him. God's precious gift he gave. Christ child was born to save. Spread hope and joy to everyone. Come, they told me, this is how it's done. Spend your money, find things for everyone. Accumulating worldly things doesn't matter much to me. Cause when you stop and think about it, the best things in life are free. But what about a girl like me who hasn't much to give? Can I celebrate the Savior's birth without expensive gifts? Now it doesn't mean that I've come without an offering. What I have is free. from my heart just for the newborn king. I'll play my drum for him. I'll give my best to him. God's precious gift he gave. Christ child was born to save. Spread hope and joy to everyone. I'll play my drum for him. I'll give my best to him. God's precious gift he gave. Christ child was born to save. Spread hope and joy to everyone. Whatever you do, just make sure you give it from your heart. Take the time to teach someone. Give it from your heart. Share a hug, share a smile. Give it from your heart. Read a book to a little child. Give it from your heart. Fall on your knees and pray for me. Yeah, do it from your heart. Yeah. I haven't much to give, just me and my drum, just me and my drum. Just me and my drum. Ooh, yeah. You gotta give it from your heart.
Anything else from this interview with the lovely Rhonda Thomas, you gotta give it from your heart. May God bless you all and keep you. We will see you tomorrow.